Good evening, and welcome to another episode of On the Inside Looking In. I am your girl, your host, Queen Diva, and I'm coming to you right in the middle of my staycation. Y'all done cut the monkey for the last time, audience. Yes, I'm on vacation. I'm celebrating 41 years of living. Thank you all for the outpouring on Facebook. Oh my goodness. The love that you all showed me on yesterday, it did not make any sense. I felt like I really was queen. Thank you again for all of the warm birthdays, the shout outs. I really, really appreciate them. So much love out there that you all have for Queen Diva. And I cannot move forward until I send a special shout out to the crew that helped me do it last night. I'm paying for it today, however. But a big shout out to the angels, Keisha Eggerson and Cecilia Ross. Thank you all so much. Karen Stewart, David McGinnis, and my boo, Sinclair Fogle. Thank y'all so much. We did it up last night, and I promise you, I am paying for it today. Big shout out goes out to you all for the mad love that you all showed last night. I really, really appreciate it. I said, you know, last night being my birthday, we were going behind the veil. The veil probably was going to get torn. And after having to come from behind the veil today to address this alarming question that has broke out in a wildfire concerning if a Christian can be antisocial. Now, what I want to first say is this, because we're going to go ahead and get right into this topic. So many people has reached out to me about this question to the degree that some are really, really taking it very, very personal in terms of if a Christian can be considered antisocial. Now, what I want to state is, coming to me and asking me what my opinion is, understand, audience, this is just Queen Diva's opinion. I'm not taking a stance or a side on it. This is just my opinion. And I must put this disclaimer out and remind you guys from the very beginning, this is a talk show. And as a host of a talk show, we have opinions. That's what we do every day. So I'm going to go ahead and jump right into it and give you my stance on it. Can a Christian be antisocial? And my answer is helicopter no. What in the world we got doing being antisocial? Now, my phone just rang, and I believe this may be a viewer. Caller, can you state your name and where you're calling from?
Yes, my name is Mose Benjamin Jr., and I'm calling from Norwood, North Carolina.
Thank you for calling into the show. Can you give us your opinion or your stance on if you believe a Christian can be antisocial?
Definitely not.
And why do you say definitely not so strongly?
Well, the thing of it is that all of us are supposed to be Christ-like. Now, the Bible teaches us that we must love ye one another as Christ has loved us. And the Bible also teaches that that we must learn that we must make our enemies our footstool. And another thing is that the Bible also teaches is that he tells us to pray for those that despitefully use us, bless those that curses us. Now, if we're going to be Christians, how can we love our enemies? How can we love those that are snobbish and antisocial? And what we say we love God, we can't do both at the same time. Now, we know that we have people in every church that act uppity, that act snobbish, especially those that have titles in the churches. Those are the main ones that kind of think they're more than everybody else. But you have to pray for those people. You have to love them. Treat them with the love that God has given you to treat them with, and go on and put a smile on your face, because the thing of it is, if you act like they act, then somebody going to miss out on a blessing. So you have to pray for those people that are antisocial and love them, treat them nice, and just go on like it don't even bother you. But you cannot be a Christian and be antisocial in the house of God.
Okay, caller, can I, when you're saying, and I agree, my stance on it is, I don't believe that a Christian, somebody that says that they are a representative of Christ, can be antisocial, because to be antisocial means that you're not willing, according to Webster. Now, you know I do my research, audience. I don't come at y'all all the time just out of what I think. But I looked up antisocial, and according to Webster, antisocial means unwilling to associate in a normal or friendly way with other people. So if we're saying that we're antisocial, how are we expanding the kingdom by drawing others if we're not willing to associate in a normal or friendly manner? I mean, how are we begetting others if we are antisocial, is my question. Can we be effective winners to Christ if we're saying that we're antisocial? Caller?
Definitely not. We can't, because the thing of it is, in order for us to have joy and power, we have to have love and power. And we love Christ and we love people. The thing of it is, we draw people with love. The Bible says, if you lift his name up, he'll draw men unto him. You can't draw people when you're antisocial, when you want to be anti-different from everybody else. Now, the thing of it is, I don't know what causes people to be this way. I don't know why they're this way. I don't know what makes them want to choose to be anti in the body of Christ. But the thing of it is that the world is watching on how we carry ourselves as Christians. Now, the thing of it is, Christians are not just in those four walls on Sunday morning. This is something that we carry out throughout our community, on our jobs, everywhere. And we do not never know whose lives that are being affected by the people that watches us in the community. People know when you carry yourself as a Christian. And when you act like you're different or want to be snobbish towards other people, then we need to think about, you know, who we're serving. Now, see, if we want to be antisocial, we need to build our own little church and say, listen, we just want to be the antisocial church of God. Don't put God in this, the antisocial church.
I love it. I love it, caller. Mr. Caller, you said something. I love that last point. Building your own church, and it's going to be called Anti-Social Church of God. I like that. Mr. Caller, can I ask you another question? You sound like, I mean, you have a lot of great insight on this topic, and you seem very passionate, as so many of my other viewers that have written in and contacted me about this subject. But you said something in your last piece. You said you don't know what causes people to be antisocial. Here's the point that I want to make. In terms of being antisocial, that says to me, I'm not doing nobody. But when you pick and choose who you're going to socialize with, then to me, it's no longer an antisocial situation. It sounds like to me, there are some situations that need to be dealt with, and people just not choosing to deal with it. They're tap dancing around the issue opposed to dealing with it head on. So my question to you is, can you pick and choose who you're going to socialize with and say that you're antisocial?
No, you cannot. You cannot do that, because the thing of it is, now we know we have people that sometimes we have people in the church that can hinder you from where you want to go in Christ. But the thing of it is that we need to do like the Bible says. Jesus said this, choose you this day whom you're going to serve.
That's what he said.
The thing of it is we're going to either choose to serve God or we're going to choose to serve man. Now, the thing of it is, my opinion is this, when we are antisocial, there is an enemy inside of us that we need to get rid of, because that enemy is telling us that we're better than everybody else. And if that enemy is speaking to you and talking to you and telling you, hey, I'm better than everybody else, you need to pray and ask God for some deliverance, because there are no antisocial people in the body of Christ. Either you are a Christian or you're not. Now, there are two types of people in the church. There are Christians and there are religious folks. And religious folks are are the antisocial people because they keep mess going all the time in the church. Christian people are trying to find a way to work together. That's where we find very few folks in that kind of a church are Christian people, because you find very few Christian people that will try to keep the antisocial and the people that are trying to be real together, because a lot of people, the devil loves confusion. And antisocial people love confusion. Wow. If I'm antisocial, I'm saying I'm better than you. And I'm saying that I don't need, I got it going on. I feel like that you can't tell me anything because I know more than you. I'm above you. I look down on you.
And
that is not in the body of Christ. So antisocial people need to get that enemy. See, the biggest enemy is yourself. Enter me is yourself. Enemy means enter me. So there's an inter part in you that is saying to yourself that I am better than everybody in this church or in every other church, wherever you are. I'm better. I know more. And I'd rather just keep it to myself. Because, see, you got a lot of cliques in the church. You got some cliques here, cliques there, and they want to They want to socialize with their own people in this corner. But the thing of it is, if we are a body, see, this is the part we need to realize. When we are a body, a body has a head, a toe, a leg, arms, feet. We all work together. That part of the body cannot work unless the other part of the body works. If we're going to be different, then we don't need to be to belong to the body of Christ, because the body of Christ simply means that we are one body, we are one spirit, and we are one church. And there are no antisocial people in the body of Christ. And antisocial people cannot, they have no place in the body of Christ. Because, first of all, you have too many antisocial people as it is in these churches. That's why churches are not growing. Because there are too many antisocial people in the church. No people trying to pull this gap together. And I'm telling you, when the majority of these churches, when you find out, when you go to a lot of these churches, you have more antisocial people than you have Christian people. And that's why a lot of these churches aren't growing like they should be. But no antisocial people have no place in the body of Christ.
Wow. Mr. Caller, you had a lot to say on this subject. Your insight was very, very weighted with substance. And I like the fact that you pointed out the principles, the foundation of the word, and simply broke it down. We cannot be representatives of Christ if we are saying that we are antisocial. Now, what my stance on it, and it has not changed, but someone said to me, I believe that a Christian can be antisocial. There's nothing wrong with just saying hi and moving on. What is your take on the ones that's in their mind saying that there's nothing wrong with a Christian being antisocial? My thing is this, in a nutshell, I believe it's greater than being antisocial. I really believe that there are hidden issues that need to be addressed. And the thing that has happened, the enemy does not want you to feel like you're going to be the first one to say, I'm sorry, I messed up. It's okay to ask for forgiveness. It's okay to apologize. It's okay to say, I messed up. And oftentimes, we can get into situations and we'll be refusing to say, well, I'm not going to call them. I'm not going to be the first one to approach it. I'm just not going to have anything else to say or deal with them. And that, to me, is just avoiding the issue. And so what becomes a little sore can actually become a huge epidemic and affect an entire body, an entire church, if it's not dealt with.
Well, I'll tell you, if I can briefly go back to something you said earlier, it brought a highlight to this subject, is that we have a lot of antisocial people in the church that think that once a person in the church messes up, that they are marked for life, they are nobodies, and they can be forgiven. Now Jesus said that he takes all of our sins, all of our wrongdoings, all of our mistakes, all of our bad habits, no matter how many times we mess up, but he puts it into a place called a seal of forgiveness. And the thing of it is with us is that we can't forget or forgive, because we can forgive, but we still gonna bring it back up. And we still still going to throw it back. Because this is where the antisocial people come in at. Because we have a lot of people in my church, your church, or everybody else's church that I don't care who, it doesn't matter how many times you do wrong, that you're always going to be looked down on as a person that does wrong. Now, if Jesus can pick us up and turn us around, then the thing of it is, we should not worry about the antisocial people that are always looking down on us, because if Jesus forgives us, then that's enough. I have a problem with some of these churches that want to put young people on the spotlight because they get out here and make a mistake. They get out here and do something wrong. Because, see, a lot of these older people doesn't realize, does not wrong, the antisocial people doesn't realize is this, is that they've been through the same ordeal that these young people are going through now. Now, they might have done it a little different than they did, but they still made some mistakes.
Mr. Collar, that is such an awesome point that you just highlighted concerning the youth. That's a whole nother subject in itself because, like you said, we fail to realize and remember from whence we came. Remembering when we were that age, what we were doing. And like you said, we may not have done what they're doing today, but we was doing just if not worse than what they're doing today. So holding the youth at a standard, and that's why a lot of them are not in the church, just because it's very judgmental, unfortunately, in this place that we call going to the house of God. Mr. Carl, I want to thank you so much for calling in. I really appreciate your view and opinion. I'm going to go ahead and wrap up my show because you know I have limited time right now. We're working on that of getting more time. You had awesome insight. If you can hang the line, I would like to speak with you offline, Mr. Caller, as I wrap up my show. I do want to say to you, audience, before I let you go, I want to remind you the origin of On the Inside Looking In. O'Tilly is the show that discusses topics that everybody else is talking about in the four walls of their home, and they're not willing to come out in the forefront. That's why O'Tilly exists. I'm just reminding you that I'm bringing it to the forefront because everybody else is talking about it behind closed doors. Contact Queen. If you're not willing to talk about it, Queen will. I will say to you, O'Tilly audience, everyone that's listening, if you have a situation that's going on with you personally and you know that it has you acting unseemly and not quite yourself, I say to you on tonight, and this real talk, you know, I normally come at you just, and I still do, with a little joker here, a little took a bone, took a fancy there, but real talk on tonight, if you are dealing with a situation that you know that it's not quite right with your sister or brother, because that's my stance on this whole antisocial deal, I don't really believe it's antisocial. I believe it's something greater going on that we as saints of God are refusing to deal with. We feel like we are blessing ourselves by saying, I'm sorry, I want to get this straight, whatever it is, I want to clear the air. At the end of the day, it will be big of you to reach out, be the bigger person to say, I'm going to deal with this, and Satan, I'm going to put you under my feet where you belong, because right now, people are confused and wondering whose side is you really on? Are you on the Lord's side? Or have you done slipped over? Hey, I'm just saying, it's brought to me, so I'm bringing it out. Ain't no need you getting all up, puffed up, and this and that and the other with Queen. This is what I do. And y'all know my motto. I'm not changing because I'm on vacation, and I'm definitely not changing because this is the topic. If you are getting upset about tonight's episode, then I must be talking to you. If you want to let this come between you and On the Inside Looking In, then that's one more person you got to pray about and come and deal with and get that out your heart. And if you don't like my views and opinion, then I do what I tell everybody else to do. The line is growing. Get at the back of the line. I want to say this also before I let you go. In love, real talk, reach out. Turn the searchlight on tonight. Turn the searchlight on tonight. And if you know that there's a situation out there that have you acting unseemly and you're not acting yourself, you better get that thing straight. You better get that thing straight, because guess what? Your walk is more valuable than this little friendly mess that the enemy, he's so slick and cunning that he want to throw our way and cause us to get tripped up. Because I'm a firm believer. At the end of the day, my daddy says this, and I hold on to this. If you are a member of a church and you go to that church every Sunday and you dismiss and you don't speak to nobody and you going out that door, there's something wrong with that picture. There is something wrong with that picture. Let's get it together. Let's get it together. I hope that Otilly has done service to all of you that have emailed me and contacted me about this subject. Kind of sank. Then where did it even come from? Nevertheless, tonight we letting it go. I'm believing God that you're going to let it go and you're going to get it together. I love you for real. With everything I got on the inside of me, I love you for real. And until next week, if you are wondering about Queen, I just might be on the sand somewhere. Yeah, letting water run through my toes, because I told you this is the whole month of celebration. My husband's birthday is Monday coming. Mine was yesterday. Celebrating every day. Until next week, know that Queen Diva loves you. Find someone to love on tonight, because at the end, we only have each other. Big shout out to you, Norwood, North Carolina, that shut it down. Give it up for Norwood, North Carolina. Mr. Mose Benjamin that called in with awesome insight on that subject. I told y'all we're going to have to take up an offering for him, because he did a little mini sermon. Until next week, we'll do it all over again. I love you. Good night.